But the battle here should be quite fascinating. Again, percentage-wise, if I were to guess, I would imagine most people heavily favor Feng Tianwei. They've never played before. They have a 0-0 record on the World Tour playing against each other. So we will see Feng Tianwei to start. Not the most tested here in the first point. Not the typical point quality. I think we'll see a lot stronger as they feel each other's game out and start to develop in the match. And Lily with that quick, dangerous backhand. I talked in her match about the sweet spot on the backhand side. Liu Shiwen could avoid it quite regularly. Although there were several games where Lily played some quite tight points with Liu Shiwen. Little break off the net for Lily, but she takes 2-1 lead here. For me, generally, when she goes aggressive, she just seems to, if there were any nerves or any reason to be nervous here, it seems like they're all just shaken out with the speed.
Joy.
And backhand as well, keeping the pressure on. Strong start for the underdog, USA's Lily Zhang. A little bit long, soft spinny opening, but Feng Tianwei is there for the counter. You can see in terms of footsteps, Lily Zhang can reach the ball quite well. Again, she's taller than the average woman right now on the World Tour, and all the opponents she's played in the last rounds, other than Sofia Polkanova, she has a few inches on. Shots, and neither of them back more than a step behind the table. Feng Tianwei right at the back. Lily Zhang just constantly keeping the racket high, and finally a shot that goes long. Outstanding play. The wall, Feng Tianwei pulls through. And that ties up the game. First towel break, 3 points apiece. I expect more like this throughout. Now, one thing Lily Zhang will have the advantage on for me, spin game. I feel power and spin. Feng Tianwei will be more consistent, compact, and quick. Wouldn't be surprised to see a few points where Lily Zhang is backed behind the table, pushed off by Feng Tianwei. Goes for broke, gets way low, and counters right down the line. A parallel shot, just inside, rather. But watch where she takes this from, how low she has to get. Touches ground, that whole right leg was almost there. Again, I've referenced Fan Zhendong before, but Lily's agility out here. Sorry. Oh, and a break off the edge. Anything to get the ball back in play, just gets the racket up in time, floats it back, and a bit of fortune here coming down. Never give up shot. Quick to apologize, Lily Zhang. In the lead by one now. Two breaks in a row. Well, now. I decided that I am going to start counting. I always say who's counting and roughly estimate, but I'm just curious. Stat that I think would be fun to keep. Hopefully I'm not off with just two so far, but either way, Lily Zhang in the lead, 6-4. Excellent placement. Feng Tianwei keeps the weight forward. He Kui in the corner. Coach for Feng Tianwei has been training several of the strong players, several of the top players in the world rankings. Good timing. Gets Lily just rocked back a little bit to cover the middle with the forehand, creating the opening. Good recovery of the net here. I'm only going to keep track when they win the point for a player. Tied up at 6 points apiece. So Feng Tianwei in her last round, the semifinals, was able to serve quite consistently long to the corners of the table, deep to the backhand. I haven't seen Lily Zhang step in for Chiquita's banana flicks over the table too much. So I expect her to be quite neutral and ready for a long serve, shall it come in.
Oh,
This receive was lukewarm, caught in between. A push that was long, but not quite deep enough nor fast enough to surprise Feng Tianwei. Again, the specifics. Anything that's played lukewarm or without very serious intention right now, Feng Tianwei will take advantage of.
6-8.
So 4 points in a row for the 33-year-old in red, Feng Tianwei. I think it was 2014, Athlete of the Year in Singapore, but right around that time on Singapore Airlines, I saw Feng Tianwei's face in the back of the seat in front of me. What coverage from Feng Tianwei, the corners. Lily Zhang hit the corners perfectly. 3 shots in a row, and Feng Tianwei was there for every single one. Look at this reach. Gets back to the opposite corner without even getting her left foot down between the shots. That is quite impressive. Pushed back behind the table a little bit. Lily Zhang reacting, but Feng Tianwei on top of the table. The speed game paying off. Has 4 game points to take the first. That's 6 in a row since down 4-6. Shovel serve, and it's countered right back after the opening attack from Lily Zhang. Spinny and low, but still no problem for Feng Tianwei. Outstanding finish to game number one from Singapore's top paddler, as they say. A lot of spin and enough speed, but the placement just perfect. Game one for Feng Tianwei. We'll be back for game number two right after this. Two, Lily Zhang down 0-1. We've seen her come back from 2-3 in the quarterfinals and even the round before, the round of 16 against the Hurricane. A shovel serve of her own and controlling the middle of the table. Turns for the finishing forehand. We saw the statistics from last game, how much prevalence there was in terms of the middle of the table, waiting for the opportunity to go wide to the wings. And she has to be selective in doing that because Feng Tianwei is so good at using the opportunity from the opponent to go wide back. Get a clever receive inside the table, sharp into the corner. 1 point apiece between the two women fighting for bronze. Rallies, this will be a secret, and by secret I mean a key ingredient for Lily Zhang. I don't know about a secret, simply that when she does go for the attack, as topspin coming in, that she plays big, takes a few risks. Yes, she'll miss some, but that's the risk she has to take. Play a high enough percentage, you win this match. Of course, the short game crucial as well. Service of Feng Tianwei, very well practiced. A good in between service length here, half long. Nothing long enough for Lily to clearly see an opening attack opportunity. Two points apiece now. Once again, a similar shot to the one that beat Lily in game number one. Serves it barely off the table, gets a pretty impressive shot. Counters back safely to the length of the table. Only safe in terms of the placement on the table. Obviously the shot, not an easy ball to play. Ooh, right down the line, Feng Tianwei changing up the timing a bit. Fans watch curiously again. It must be like seeing someone you've never seen before. I don't think I needed the word like at all. It's not really a comparison. Here in China, you're used to the stars. People know Ding Ning. They know Liu Shiwen. A handful of others, maybe, if they're following the sport in the women's game. And they will know more and more with Sun Yingsha, Wang Manyu, Chun Meng, Zhu Yuling, possibly. But for them, Lily Zhang is new to the show. And for most of the world, for that matter, outside of the Pan-American competitions, where she's a well-known celebrity and star. Feng Tianwei, of course, international recognition for over a decade now. Bit off the top of the net for Lily. Looking around the stadium here, what a show. Again, these women, among the other women of the world right now, the 20 that qualified to be here, putting on spectacular play. And this time it's role reversal. Lily Zhang manages to get Feng Tianwei behind the table. Only 12 shots, but in terms of the positioning, Feng Tianwei from a bit behind, trying to abbreviate the strokes with the forehand. Now it's Lily with the shorter strokes in the timing. Big game here for confidence and to add some nerves to the opponent. Put a bit of pressure on the upper seed. And it comes down on Lily's side of the table. Attempted short serve to the forehand. Maybe half long. I think it's a good idea to change up the placement, but this gift for Feng Tianwei, well, that's the risk. It's the cost of playing risky, no problem. To be expected.
6-5.
So Lily right now, for me, that last point looks caught a little bit in between decisions. That hesitation, I think, is why we saw the frustration and the foot stomp. She plays it soft, she can control it. She plays it fast and aggressively. There's still a pretty good chance she can control it.
In
the second half of game six against Miu Hirano and Sofia Polkanova, she got very aggressive, Lily Zhang, and played fearlessly like she had nothing to lose, and there was no stopping her. Doesn't miss by a lot, but at least the placement of the receive is right at the baseline. Feng Tianwei doing an excellent job of still causing trouble from behind the table. Two points down at the second towel break. It's funny, in the Americas right now, Hugo Calderano, Adriana Diaz, both have been leaders that have left both continents, cheering and watching with great excitement. But Lily Zhang, again, creating history for USA. Another one off the top of the net. Funny, in terms of the shots that she's missed on hesitation, I think she's been quickly balanced out with a bit of luck and fortune. With the wide stance of Lily Zhang, I think sumo squat was the term I heard from the physio, one of the physios from the Chinese national team who helped train Lily with Zhu Yuling in Los Angeles. And the Chiquita goes long. Banana off the table. Nothing between them now point-wise. Experience and the serves on Feng Tianwei's side. Oh, back edge, a little luck comes back for Feng Tianwei. Sets her up by 1 point. So the long shovel serve came out last serve to get quickly into the point. Feng Tianwei trying to stay unpredictable. Oh, those backhands are so fast. The two to the backhand side first. And then later in the rally, Feng Tianwei able to finish the point with the widest angle we've seen in that rally. 2-point lead, game closer already than game one. While anything's possible, being down 0-2 for the underdog, world ranked number 49 with the serve. Lily Zhang looking straight back, get into this game. Ooh, change of pace here. Now from the looks of things, again from our camera angle, thanks for the other opportunity, we'll have a look here. That ball sits a little bit inside the table and higher than usual. That's normally a gift for Feng Tianwei. Hence the head nod, the well, what are you gonna do nod. Eight serving nine. Backhand punch, just a moment late to get in to catch it at its peak. Right idea for sure. Lily Zhang has made several points this way, converted a handful with that backhand punch after the float serve. Light rotation, you can almost read the label on the ball. Well, they've exchanged. In all fairness, they both missed shots that seem quite reasonable for them late in game number two. Two game points for Feng Tianwei. The flick right down the middle. Feng Tianwei's versatility on that forehand flick. It's clearly well practiced and it's paid off on several occasions so far today. The serve to set it up and the flick to knock it down. Feng Tianwei up 2-0 over USA's Lily Zhang. Still a long way to go. It's a best of four for the bronze medal. Let's see what happens. Game three coming up right after this.
我们过会儿呢会一起来看看大家都有什么想对自己的偶像说的当然还要提醒大家的是在今天赛事结束之后我们还会抽出由我们的赞助商成都航空提供到的两个飞机模型大号送给大家当然我们的奖品还有来自郑一清的签名球拍时装家主的签名球拍朱雨的签名球拍以及刘世伦的签名抱枕还有更是让今天的礼物让父母现场所有的朋友们希望大家踊跃参与到我们活动当中来
Players back for game number three. The Cinderella story, Lily Zhang at the top of the screen, down 0-2 against Feng Tianwei, the ever so experienced, one of the greatest threats to the Chinese. Singapore's hero Feng Tianwei to start game three with the serve. And almost right back to the corner. Feng Tianwei's covered the wings very well. Again, in terms of training, she's been working a lot with many of the top in the world.
Love to.
Lily a bit surprised, ball coming down into the net. We don't see players look down at the equipment too often. Maybe a few times a match. The international sign for, I thought I did everything right. The backhand exchange, still that first game, had that one rally early on that really set the bar. Lily Zhang is gonna do everything she can to get Feng Tianwei to turn from the middle and play a forehand. Just have to backpedal a little bit to give space at the table, earn some time for a bigger shot. Oh, what play here. Feng Tianwei anticipates. Says, I'll go for it. I'll take your bait. I'll push long to you and open up the corner the other way because I have a confident feeling I know where you're going to go. This is experience that we see in Timo Boll. Again, Feng Tianwei of the top 10, just outside the top 10 now. But of the players in the top 10, the senior most for a long time. Again, the Chinese national team rarely sees a woman play with any consistency on the world tour into her 30s. Ding Ning, 29 right now. Liu Shuan, 28. Feng Tianwei, 33.
Two four.
Good deception with the spin on the shovel serve. Feng Tianwei coming into the towel break in the lead. This is the game for Lily Zhang. She wants a chance to come back. Coming into game number four, down 1-2 with a bit of momentum. Reminding the opponent that she's present, she's dangerous. The danger factor, I think everybody knows now after her performances against Miu Hirano, Volkanova.
2-5.
And go back into the Western way of saying that again. So timeout here for Lily Zhang. A little bit earlier, I think it's a good timeout. Don't want to wait too long in the match. The 3-point differential. Trying to listen closely there, couldn't catch much. Minor adjustments from Coach Jeffrey Tung. Again, a former Sichuan provincial player. He in the corner. For Feng Tianwei, a look at Feng Tianwei's footwork here. The wide stance. Again, the physical training and the preparation for the women of the Chinese national team makes them strong in a way that they are so well prepared to regain balance. Regain might even be the wrong term, because it's like they never really lost it. Like, they're able to just slide along, lunge where need be, and be immediately back in position for one more shot. Feng Tianwei, fans in the crowd making a little noise. Crowd was quite supportive when Lily Zhang was playing against Miu Hirano. Could have been the rivalry between Japan and China. Simply seeing a familiar last name in the U.S. is Lily Zhang. Many famous Zhangs in the table tennis world for China. Of course, Zhang Yining. Zhang Jike. Many, many others. Wow, the angular play starts in the cross-court battle. Lily Zhang using the footwork to get wide in the short side of the table, just too short for Feng Tianwei in the end of the rally. Trying to stay close, stay on top of the ball. I hope you appreciate my table tennis sign language translation. I think most table tennis players already knew. A beautiful angle from the middle again, quick play. Lily Zhang turning up the heat, says, if I'm going to go wide to your forehand, I'm going to have to race you here. One to the middle to stop you in your tracks, and quick off the bounce. Just a little bit earlier, leaves Feng Tianwei leaping towards the right side, but with no counter available. Zhang doing a good job to come back since the timeout. 3 points in a row out of the timeout, but it's Feng Tianwei in this point to regain control, gain the lead. Soft and spinny, clever idea. Lily Zhang had tried punching for power with Feng Tianwei behind the table, but when the opponent backs off, it's a good time to break their timing, force them to move back in, play a shot off balance. Trying to read what that towel said. A lot of players representing brands well, getting sponsorship. I wouldn't be surprised. Both of these players have sponsorship, but if far more, I'd say, offers for sponsorship come knocking on Lily's door after this tournament. Short side of the table, and Feng Tianwei with a closed racket this time around steps into the lead. Again, the timeout has been used for Lily Zhang, and it will have paid off only if she takes this game. Soft and spinny, but Feng Tianwei right on top of the bounce. Plays the angle wide, 2 points in the lead. Lily Zhang plays soft and spinny with Feng Tianwei at the table. It's probably going to have to be into the body right at the baseline. Something that tempts Feng Tianwei to turn. Fast exchange and the finishing backhand favors Lily Zhang in this rally within 1 point. Again, Feng Tianwei will be quite determined. A test that many have not been able to pass on screen now. Lily Zhang. Distance serve there, half long, barely coming off the table. Lily Zhang close, but again, net and just out. 2 points in front, that would have been big. 8 points apiece still, Feng Tianwei would have had the serve. She uses her serves wisely to control the point. Lily Zhang now doing anything she can to derail the third ball. Back edge of the table, a bit of fortune, Feng Tianwei. Still, I think, has one or two IOUs, but they're pretty close to even now. And it is 3 game points for Feng Tianwei to take a 3-0 lead. Good placement. Lily Zhang leaves Feng Tianwei under the table on the wide forehand to save game point. Third towel break. 2 points between them. Serves back with Lily Zhang. We'll have a chance to see the stats between games. The short to the forehand serve can be effective. But we did see it go into the net not too long ago. Lily making her choice. And the turn from Feng Tianwei takes the game 11-8. A strong turn in the middle after Lily Zhang tries to set up the point, but the backhand opening puts the pressure on and gets slightly more passive play out of Lily Zhang. Feng Tianwei, 1 game away from getting a bronze medal. Will Lily Zhang come back? It's looking grim, but never say never. She's come back before. Game number 4 of the bronze medal match coming up right after this.
请各位摇起来，当然大家在第十秒的时间当中，不要带那个提醒，向现场所有的观众，我们的现场是不允许开闪光灯的，所以请尽量关闭你们的闪光灯，以免给我们现场队员造成困扰。我们再来看看前三名分别是谁？是Christmas and ULYSSES， 看不太清楚，因为太远了。欢迎各位观众到二号厅李老头展会领取属于你的纪念品。那在下一个主持间呢，我们还会有更加精彩的活动，记得关闭闪光灯哦。
First game, Lily to serve level.
Players back to the table for game number 4. Lily Zhang trying to get the blood flowing, stay loose. From painkillers to adrenaline, whatever it takes. 1 point at a time to win this game. And she gets low once again for the down the line forehand. I thought for sure she was going the other way, but she takes the risk, leaving open the forehand side of the table. Extra heat on this last ball. The pressure for Feng Tianwei to play the open table, but just too much. And from behind the table, watching this point, I start to feel like Lily Zhang's hitting it hard, but from that far behind the table, it's going to be very tough to put the pressure on that she needs to beat Feng Tianwei. Although the timing is changed up a bit, as mentioned before, a little bit self-made. Of course, the help of the coaches and training along the way to get to where she is, but not quite the same system as some of the top countries in the world. Lily Zhang didn't grow up told at the age of 6 years old that she had skill and she should move away from her parents and join an academy. Even through college, it was just training when she could. On her own merit, going to the local club. And a slower spinny one from Feng Tianwei this time, with Lily Zhang just a step behind the table after the long, a bit like a chop, again, something between a push and a chop, but from behind the table by a step. We saw Lily Zhang chop for an outstanding point. I believe it was against Miu Hirano. Tough to recall the opponents for some of these spectacular points in this tournament for her. Just too wide. Outstanding play here in the Chula. Chole. Feng Tianwei earns it right off the bounce. Watch the timing, how early she takes this. Still rising and right on the white of the line. Has to play dangerously against Lily Zhang to beat the wide wingspan and the footwork. So first towel break tied up, 3 points apiece. Now this is their first encounter head-to-head. They've never played on the World Tour. While Lily has played a handful of matches against top 20 players, players who've spent most of their last decade, I'd say, in the top 10, not always easy to reach them. Now these are the ones where if you say, well, I saw the match, Lily versus Liu Shiwen, she had no chance. Some quite close to Lily actually told me that after watching. And score-wise, yes, it was quite one-sided, but the rallies in general, there were just fewer mistakes. Only a few shots per game, I would say. Maybe 2 shots per game Liu Shiwen hit that made me go, wow, she's on her own level. But a lot of other points, it was just she's very consistent in position, doesn't make many mistakes. Ball comes long, Lily Zhang in the lead. It seems to me that Lily Zhang has played better when she's had her back against the ropes and just realizes she has to MIB her mind, go blank and say, you know what? Play every point, nothing to lose.
4-6.
Ball just barely missing the table. I thought I heard something, so I was waiting to see if the players did too, but would have been the second time I called something that didn't happen so far. Feng Tianwei down by 2 has her serves back. A bit more rotation on the receive. Lily Zhang handcuffed into a passive receive. Says, well, if I can't surprise you with the placement, I'm gonna make you have to lift a lot. For those of you that aren't playing competitive table tennis, that ball goes straight down into the net or maybe even your side of the table if you're not well trained. Even for fellow competitors.
Left. 4-7.
It's tough to explain. I recommend going to a local table tennis club just to get a taste of what it's like. For those who know how to play with spin competitively. And if you're nice, they might even take you under their wing and invite you out for a meal and bring you back to the club. And next thing you know, you'll be competing too and really appreciate the skills that are being demonstrated out here that are just over the heads of most. Eight to four in the lead. Same lead we saw from Feng Tianwei against Zhu Yuling earlier today. There it is, catches Feng Tianwei. Looks slightly off balance, expecting another placement. Has to go up on 1 foot to try to reach this. Quick turn from the forehand and Lily Zhang right at the baseline. 58 kilometers per hour. Not the fastest shot, but the placement definitely made it count. Heavy rotation, chop block attempted. And Lily Zhang with 6 game points to start a comeback that still has a long, long journey ahead. Been so dependable. Feng Tianwei saving a game point. She has been a queen of comebacks. Seen it over the years. Again, one of the greatest comebacks I've seen was Feng Tianwei. And there it is, a slightly off-balance shot from Lily, running around to take the backhand from the forehand side. 11-5, the most dominant game we've seen yet. It's from the underdog with her back against the ropes. She keeps hope alive for the Americas, United States of America's Lily Zhang. 1-3 down. We'll be back for game five to see what she does with the momentum and what happens. Stay right here.
当然要提醒各位，关于赛事前十，欢迎到我们的互动当中可以直接丢人进来的互动。再三提醒啊，一局。谢谢提醒，我想要为欢迎各位这两位朋友呢去到二号厅，让我们两位领取属于你们的礼品。当然要提醒大家，赛事前当中有留言上传的环节，希望大家踊跃的作为你的偶像留言，为他们加油打气。希望在演讲上能看见你的身影。下个时间再会。
Players back for game number five. Momentum on Lily Zhang's side. Still, Feng Tianwei up 3-1, one game away from a bronze medal. Now, three times in Feng Tianwei's career, she's already earned this bronze medal. But an additional three times, she's also lost in the bronze medal match. That's six different times she's had the experience of being here on this stage. Trying to add some spin to the ball from the slightly punchier shots behind the table. Lily Zhang, again the distance there. It's tied up now. 1 point apiece. Lily Zhang has survived behind the table, though. In the lobbing game, I have a funny feeling Feng Tianwei with the inside-out shots, the placement would be very tough to play. Short side, and Lily Zhang takes the lead. Ball sits up for a bit. Now, variation in the spin game, especially in the short game, so important. Heavy spin off Feng Tianwei, then a very short shot. Gets a long push back and sees the opportunity. This is one thing that Liu Shiwen is incredibly consistent with and very tricky with, spin variation. No hesitation at all, quick with the racket high. Lily Zhang covering the middle and playing the backhand like a bullet back. There's one, she was starting to go forehand. You can see how high the racket is between shots. Right at the clavicle, about neck bone height. The counter burn. Feng Tianwei turning from the middle, and Lily Zhang just eating it for breakfast. Give me that spin one more time. I'd like a refill of top spin from the forehand in the middle of the table, please. No to-go bag needed. I will finish everything here at the table. 3-point lead for Lily Zhang. Again, the distance from the table, Feng Tianwei feels like she's losing the control that she had. It makes me nervous to even highlight the lead that Lily has, because we know that one, Feng Tianwei's dangerous. Two, that she can come back. We've seen it many times before. Three, she's the expected victor. I was going to say the overdog. I don't know if that's a term, but Lily Zhang definitely not expected to win this match. Playing quite strong from the start here of game number five. Top of the last one, keeps up with the speed that we've seen her play for years and years. Chinese Super League speed, covers the middle with the backhand and then wide backhand as well. Keeps the top spin on, and it just catches the top edge of Lily Zhang's racket. Cut. placement again, catching Lily Zhang with a big movement back. Again, the bigger the step, the easier it is to get caught mid-step. Someone plays it behind your momentum or into the body. It's tough to get set quickly because you have a long distance to move. Only 2 points between them now, two in a row for Feng Tianwei. Nice parallel backhand. Had Lily Zhang not won that point, it would have been the time where she would have needed a timeout, but not have it. She's already spent, and each player only gets one timeout per match. Very smart play. One more soft touch from Lily Zhang. Feng Tianwei was expecting the attack, started to back off, and Lily played an outstandingly short shot. Not easy to do as late as she did to bring Feng Tianwei back in and earn the next attack. 4-point lead once again for USA's Lily Zhang. Fast, long serve, but not quite the depth nor the surprise factor that Lily would have been hoping for on that. So far in the long service game today, Feng Tianwei has been very effective against Zhu Yuling. Out here we shall see. Second serve for Lily. Good placement here from Feng Tianwei. Parallel shot jamming up Lily Zhang. Two in a row. Again, Lily hoping for an opportunity, something with a bit more length on it, cross court to turn and play the forehand. Second towel break. The U.S. is 5-time national champion, 2-time collegiate national champion at NCTTA, and 2-time Olympian in singles and teams. Lily Zhang, again at 16 years old, first became the national champion of the U.S., did it her 5th time this year. And the streak continues. Feng Tianwei within 1 point from down 3-7. The danger is real. A 3-time bronze medalist on a roll right now. Breathing down the neck of Lily Zhang's 7 points. And a good deep push to break the momentum, get the lead back to 2. There's always hope. You can't take that, but an 8-6 lead. Much more hope for world ranked number 49. Cinderella story, Lily Zhang with the serves. Soft spin, it will not come down on the table. Doesn't miss by a lot, but Lily again with these lunging leaps to the forehand side is able to cover the table so well. Short stroke, now you can really appreciate how fast the ball is moving. This is the camera angle that will change the sport. This is the camera angle that will make people marvel at the player's abilities and go, I didn't realize the ball was moving that fast and low to the net. And a quality deep push brings Feng Tianwei back within 2 with the serves. And again, serve is quite an advantage in table tennis, especially with Feng Tianwei's history, the way she's been playing today alone. For me, the last year of Feng Tianwei's career has actually been an up in the career. Lily quick off the bounce with the backhand from the middle of the table earns herself 3 game points. Again, to even be this deep in the tournament is so unlikely that pretty much every table tennis fan in the United States is staying up no matter what time this is to watch it live. But to be up 10-7 right now in game number 5. Perfect angle. Feng Tianwei quick off the bounce, finds the deep corner, saves game point. Third towel break, and again, the more experienced, the world ranked number 12, Feng Tianwei, with a very compact backhand, brings in Lily over the table on the forehand side, one to the middle to freeze her up for a moment, and as deep to the corner as can be, this precision makes Feng Tianwei so dangerous. Still 2 game points left, serves back with Lily. play, gets on the defensive, and from behind the table, immediately turns back into the offensive game. Heavy topspin from behind the table. The last shot, 67 kilometers per hour. Only a handful of times something has broken 70. She was behind the table on that. Two game points saved. One more to go. Lily Zhang with the second serve here. The backhand goes long. Three game points saved. Feng Tianwei more than halfway there. The crowd shifting in their seats. Lily just trying to reset play point for point. It's very tough to clear your mind to be free after having three game points not converted. Serve for Feng Tianwei. But the aggressive forehand and the follow-up backhand earns a fourth game point. Lily Zhang, another chance. Redemption, serve on her side. Again, if you leave the stadium when it looks like it's over, you miss the greatest comebacks that history has ever known. Lily was down 0-3 and now has her fourth opportunity to take it to game number six. Quick backhand finds the net and out. Deuce once again, Feng Tianwei saves. Now, no matter who wins this, there's no question that it would be more exciting, more thrilling if it ends in game number seven. Successfully. Again, the forehand of Lily Zhang has been dangerous simply because it's different every time, but Feng Tianwei controls the point, has saved four game points, and now has her first match point for a bronze medal. So many moments where it felt like Feng Tianwei had just put too much pressure on. Lily behind the table by two clear steps. You can see this distant lunging and leaping to cover the corners. I haven't had asthma in over two decades, but just watching this, I think I need an inhaler. Talk about physical conditioning. 33 years old. Playing someone 10 years younger. The points just keep getting better. Feng Tianwei in a tremendous rally. Told by He Keyi in the corner, pin her in the middle, hit it at the shoulder, just inside that right shoulder, get her in the chest. She'll turn for the forehand, and the backhand's gonna be slow to get there. We will see second match point for Singapore's Feng Tianwei. The angle, Lily catches the edge of the table going wide cross court. The excitement right now, I don't know if there's a limit, but they keep extending it. A bend on this ball, still a pretty good bounce, but a little bit of help from the edge of the table. See the ball kicking out wide. That angle made it a bit more clear how it extended out of reach. Fourth deuce point. Feng Tianwei with the serves has been strong in setting up a point where she's in control. Again, the only shot in the rally that you can determine without any question. The serve and heavy underspin here. Lily immediately checking her racket to see if there was a wet mark. Ball going down quickly into the bottom of the net. No wet mark for Lily. One match point. Once again, third match point for Feng Tianwei. performance from both players. Feng Tianwei was just too strong in the end, but what a show indeed. Again, Lily Zhang making quite an exciting show in this tournament. Nobody expected her to get out of her group, let alone the round of 16, the quarterfinals, and all the way to the bronze medal match. But Feng Tianwei, for the fourth time in her illustrious career, will be medaling here today over USA's Lily Zhang. A proud moment for both nations, Singapore and the United States, no question about it. Feng Tianwei, 4-1. Again, the score line, if you only see the game score, will not tell the full story. But Lily Zhang with a massive comeback in the fourth. And in game number five, from down 7-10, the wise and experienced, quick and efficient on her way back up in the world, Feng Tianwei has taken the bronze medal. Congratulations, Feng Tianwei. You placed your balls just perfectly, and you placed yourself on the bronze medal podium later today. Singapore will be quite happy, along with many of your fans around the world. Let's hear what the bronze medalist Feng Tianwei has to say, and then stick around for the vengeance match between the top two seeds right here in Chengdu. Down on court to Feng Tianwei.
Congratulations, star! You won third place of the Women's World Cup. And would you like to share with us the feelings right here, right now? 恭喜您获胜。那么此时此刻，跟大家分享一下您的心情，好吗？
还是很开心的吧。然后，达到了预期的目标。赛前的目标是进前八，没想到拿第三。谢谢大家。
I'm quite satisfied with my performance today, and I will thank every spectator, I will thank everyone for supporting me. Thank you. 让我们再次把掌声送给冯天威。